Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jeff. So in this video, we're gonna check out SuperM's 100 dance practice. So this one came out a month ago, and it took me a little bit longer to get to it. But I still remember when it first kind of got teased. Most people didn't really like the teased parts, and then it came out and it obviously received mixed reaction. I still like it because it does have some great high notes and some great dancing, from what I remember anyway, but I don't remember the song clearly. It's been a while since I listened to this song, so this is gonna be very nostalgic for me. But before we get to it, just want to let you guys know that I will be reacting to the SMCU concert, so that will be available on my Patreon. Link will be down below. Okay, let's go. Okay, you know what? Like, I watched a little bit of it and I'm already like freaking out. I feel like I'm listening to this song for the first time again, just because it's been a long time since I listened to this song and watched the video and all that. So I'm gonna just react to it, the entire thing first, before I dissect, you know?
Day one, we got is the way they
Let's go, Timmin.
We go straight to the top. We go 100.
Oh, dang, the footwork. Whoa, oh, the turn. Okay, top notch at the spot like a jackpot. Hey, we belong high up top. God, Mark Lee. Bring us down, but we got too hot all around. Not optional. We be unstoppable. Yeah, coming through like a wrecking ball. I actually really like this song. I know it was quite divisive at the time. There's a lot of footwork in this. Okay. Your hands. Bacon. Hey. There's a lot of footwork. It's actually very intricate. It didn't seem like that on the music video. Hey. A lot of dynamics. Hold on, I'm sorry. Taeyong, I just have to point out quickly, because I'm gonna forget this for sure. Like Kai. Oh my god, you guys know I love Kai. he's just like doing that, you know, pointing and stomping, but like it's so sharp. Like what? Sorry. My crowd, let's give this something they've been talking about. I said, say yeah. Are you with me? You might be a boss, but we run this city like foot to the floor. There ain't no taming the beast. I would also not be surprised if Taeyong had a say in the choreography, because this is so him. It's like so his style. Yes, Tenley. Hey. Love the shoulder work. That's snap. Oh, beautiful. Jesus. Oh my goodness. Never fall, never quit, never stop. Boom, 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 boom. Walking like we own it. Hey. I remember that part. Jesus. This is crazy. Ooh, the lines. Thank you, SMP4. Oh my god. First of all, oh yeah. This choreography is intense. And why does it feel like this song is more appropriate now? Like, I feel like, if I can remember correctly, before, you know, when it first came out, I think there was such a whiplash to this song, and I don't think it was received as well. I can even remember, like, you know, some SM songwriters, was it, saying that they were surprised that SM picked this as like a pre-release title track. I feel like now, looking back at it now, I feel like if this was released now, I don't think anyone would like raise an eyebrow, you know, because I feel like this song was ahead of its time. Like, just listen to the vocals, to the instrumentation of it. It's quite complex, and it doesn't feel so out of place anymore. It doesn't feel like cut in different pieces and just shoved in together, because I feel like there's a lot of songs that feel like that nowadays. I feel like this kind of somewhat modernized that, or like made, like almost pioneered that. I don't really want to say pioneer, because there's another, I believe what you guys told me before, is like there's a Girls' Generation song that was very whiplashy, because like of like Next Level before. I was like, whoa, that's a whiplash. And then you guys were saying that there's a Girls' Generation one that was kind of whiplashy too. But like before Next Level, we had 100, and this was, I feel like, was what was mentioned, is like it kind of didn't fit well together. I don't know if it's because I've adapted to it or I know what to expect, but it feels very relevant now. Like, if this song was released now, it would do well. Obviously, Tiger Inside was still top notch, like over this one, right? Okay, let's dissect this. I just love that the intro for this, because it feels like we were in the middle of a song, and it's almost like going, like repeating, because this section too repeats later on. And normally the introduction of a song in choreography don't repeat later, and it did repeat like around this time frame. Where is it? I'll point it out later, but it does repeat. And it was just like, whoa, that's so cool, because it doesn't normally happen that way. And yeah, it feels like we're in the middle of the song, because it feels like they're walking already, and then boom, and they kind of just like stepped into it. And like the intricacies of the arm work and the hands. And we come coming ready or not. We go straight to the top. And they're going straight into a jump. Like, that's so energetic. And it fits that superhero-like movement in the instrumentation. This is such a great rap from Mark. I love that part. I remember that part, like when it goes up and then down. I love the levels. Okay, wait. The footwork. We're losing it a bit because it's a lot of steps. So that kind of thing, if you get, even for experienced dancers, it will take a little bit to get that footwork down to a T, like very tight with the music, with the other person, what the moves are, because that was a lot. It was a lot of different things. It was a lot of different footwork within a short time frame. So like memory-wise, it would take a little bit longer than normal to remember that, because it's a lot, it's quick, and it's tight. At the same time, you know, you can't make a mistake because you have another person or two dancing with you, so it needs to be as cohesive energy-wise, needs to be very synchronized, right? Because memorization you achieve through repetition, right? You just keep repeating it so that it becomes embedded in your head and in your body for your muscle memory. So what I can even see myself, if I was learning this, if I was, you know, one of them, like if I have another schedule and I'm like just chilling, I would just be doing that part, you know, just so that I can like get in my head and not forget the combination. My only thing about that section is it's so focused on the foot that we forgot the arms. So I wish there was a little more establishment of where the arms is supposed to be, because like if you look at it, like the arms is kind of not established. Like I think it's supposed to be on the sides, which makes sense, because sometimes when the foot is just so heavy in choreography, the focus is there and we forget our arms. But it's nothing huge. Love that level too, from like down to up, you know, like, and that, oh, you know, it's just so much more impactful when you have such a big dynamic change. And then like that 10 min and 10 there, just like being so synchronized, like the energy down to the hands were so synchronized. And I believe that's because their style of dancing is quite reminiscent with each other. Of course, there are some differences too, but like both are very fluid dancers. So like when you put two fluid dancers side by side doing the same things, it's going to be a lot more synchronized, because the way they bend, the way they move, it's going to be very similar, as opposed to like having one very fluid dancer and a very sharp, kind of like edgy dancer. And then this bend, you can already like can see Kai's like the body roll there is so specific. Like look, it starts from that boom and then the chest. So that is the same idea as the extension that I've mentioned before. I don't know if there's a term for it. I don't think there is, but like it's basically that kind of elongated period of time where you're not doing much. So what you need to do is to fill in the space. So you can't go finish right up the body roll right away, because you're not going to have anything for the rest of that section, that small section. So for example, Kai isn't the only one doing this, by the way. Like for example, Kai, with the body roll, he really took his time to get from like here, the chest, to go down to his torso, because then the entire duration of that section is filled in with the choreography, as opposed to finishing the body roll right away. It's so weird to me, because like I've listened to this song a lot before, and then now I'm listening to it back now. I remember certain sections in terms of lyrics, but I can't, for the sake of me, sing along properly. I think I can remember Lucas going a little bit harder on that transition back on the main performance, and I think one of the live stages. I feel like this was a time when Mark, because like, you know, looking at jumping to 100, like that's a year apart, right? I feel like this was the moment, this was the era where Mark, as we know him, is a lot more swaggier, is a lot more sharp and enunciated in his movements, because like this part here, like his movements is a lot more composed and mature. I feel like, yeah, this was the era that he's really molding into the shape that he is in now. I just remember that, like, you know, just being a little bit more powerful than this. But this is not to say that this is bad. I just remember it being more powerful. But I love that part. It's very, it's cool. Can't slow down, wait, I didn't see that before. That part, that... what? I don't remember seeing that ever.
Boom, 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 boom.
Look at the lines. Look at this line. Like Mark Lee. Hello. Look at this positioning. Look at that. The line. It's what the difference is that Mark's body, it's like sideways but frontwards, if that makes sense. His chest is really like quite out there, which extends his torso and makes that shape a lot more pronounced. It's gorgeous. Because I haven't danced for a while, like before. I stopped dancing into 2014, so while, because I got into acting. And I can't afford both classes. Hello, no. it's very expensive. But like, for example, I started doing like TikTok challenges again and just like learning choreo on the side for fun. And I'm realizing the things that I needed to have worked on after doing this these analysis as well, kind of applying what I say here and what I knew before to what my capabilities are now, because it's totally different. A tip that I would give you guys is to, like, these kind of, there are certain movements and choreographies on a piece where you need to establish a move, for example, this one. So it's not just like hitting the move in combination with the others. It's more like going in front of the mirror and just posing. You know, like, okay, this specific move I want to hit very nicely. So I'm just gonna go into the mirror and like fix my movement and then rehearse without music, that combination, emphasizing this slowly. And then when your muscle memory is there, then you can go faster and with the music. And then by the time that you know it, by the time that you perform it, you're establishing the movements now. And that body shape, body line that you want to have in that specific move, it will be there, rather than learning the moves, the combination on its own, and not polishing each specific move that you want to hit. Because there, in choreographies, there are certain imageries that the choreographers would want you to emphasize. And I feel like this is one of them, considering this is also the thumbnail, I think, if I can remember correctly. But yeah, that's something that you guys can do to establish certain movements and improve body lines. My crowd, let's get this up that they've been talking about. I said, say yeah. Are you with me? You might be a boss, but we run this city like foot to the floor. Love this part. Taming the beast. Wake up for first, cause we hear making history. Oh my god, I could just listen to this song. What the hell? I love the vocals in this song. Now I remember some people were like, oh, I like certain songs, certain parts of the song, and some another part, and hate the other parts of the song. I love the vocal parts and the rap parts. I don't know. I actually really like the song. Yeah, there's a lot of hand details here, and then like Lucas's turn is quite wide. It's huge. That part there, and it's a nice rotation along with Baekhyun there. That formation change is great. That transition. And then like Taemin's balance here, you know, like that centering, that like is, you have a slight tippy toe, you're like quite centered, and then you're doing all those things that actually do require a lot of balance, because you really basically only have your one leg at the back having you stand, and then your front foot is kind of like what's preventing you from like tipping forward or like, you know, just losing balance. But that, along with doing a lot of hand movements, it's like your balance shifts if you don't control it in the core. And it shifts too. It's not just steady. There's a tippy toe. There's this part, and then it goes into that part. And then it goes into the side. Like, that's a lot. There's a lot of shifting in your core and your balance. This is a hard choreo. Hey, that's so sharp. We go 100. Hey, we go, we go, we go. these hard arm movements, actually, it's a little harder to synchronize because it's a lot of detailing. It rotates. So when you rotate, there needs to be a certain placement and establishment on how your palms are going to be, so that when you rotate it, it would look the same. Plus, it's fast. So if some people are like, you know, kind of flimsy on it or like out, like you guys see the difference, there's a lot of potential ways to not make it look as good. And not just that, yeah, like that, it's a turn. And then there's this again. How do you like snap your body like that? What the fuck? I don't know. I can't tell you how to do that because I can't do that myself. Like, there's a wiggle. There's like a stiffening and then it kind of wiggles a little bit. It's a body pop. It's a pop. I'm not really good with pops. I'm more better with like fluid movements because of my training. But like this one, it's a pop. It's a body pop. It's crazy. It's just so good because there's a after effect after he does that, and there it kind of wiggles a little bit. It's so cool. Boom. Hey. This line. Look at this fucker. Beautiful. You know what I was talking about, like, you know, with Mark earlier, like looking into the mirror, establishing your moves so that when you go into the combination with it, you hit these nuances and great body lines. I feel like that's something that Taemin would do. So it's like if he's given like a choreography, I feel like he would just kind of like stare in the mirror and like just do that specific move and like polish how it looks body line wise and stuff. Because that's something that you wouldn't really automatically do if you don't have a mirror, you know? When you're learning moves, you know, you can do it to the way you're seeing it, but when you put it into the mirror, it may look a little bit different. Doing that mirror trick that I was telling you guys about, it could just be like an extra step to establishing a certain move like this one. It's just incredible, like this imagery. And I love the camera work on this. Look at the details, Mark. Look at this toe, oh my God. Like, see, it goes back to this one. Like, the intro doesn't normally repeat. That's insane. Wait. That's fast. That's fast. It's fast. And that, like, that's fast. It's all, it's doable with the upper body, but like with that last minute footwork. Boom, 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 oh God. It's crazy. These are the moments when you realize, like, I didn't say much about Baekhyun in my dropping reaction. And when I was reading comments, you know, there was a comment there that's saying that, like, you know what, we have to praise Baekhyun for being able to keep up. But I agree with that comment. You know, being able to keep up with these guys, in terms of this choreography, it's very difficult. I don't think a lot of people realize how insane these choreographies are, and that if you can keep up with this choreography and energy and detailing down to a T with the dynamics, you're a good dancer. I just think that he doesn't get a lot of choreography moments. He does have a lot of vocal moments, which makes sense, but he doesn't have a lot of key moments within the choreography. But him being able to keep up with the energy and The detailing. It's more so the detailing for me. The detailing is insane, as I've been pointing out. Walking like we own it. We go straight to the top. We go Taeyong. Hey. One more thing to point out with Kai, like, just, you know, in his sides, I'm trying to like focus on different members. Like with Kai, there's power, but he's able to control it to the point of he knows exactly how much power to put in a specific move to make it as powerful and then hold back when he needs to. I feel like it's just such mastery to a craft. It's equivalent to how a singer would do the dynamics with their vocals. Like doing runs, going loud, crescendo, decrescendo, and being able to do high notes without screaming. You know, like when people do high notes, there's the belts there are proper belts, and there are people that do belts, but it sounds like a scream. So, you know what I mean? There's just a certain control, and I think that's why he's like one of my favorite dancers. Hey. Oh my god. Without edits, this is a 37-minute reaction. Jesus. That's a lot. I don't have much to say in terms of concluding this, except like this was just, I feel like the song and choreography is just way ahead of its time. And that's why we kind of created that kind of conversation back then. I remember some people saying, it's okay if you don't like it, you don't have to lie. And I'm just like, what? I like the song. All right, thank you guys so much for watching with me today. I hope that you enjoyed it. And if you did, do like and subscribe. And if you do subscribe, make sure you tick that notification bell so you don't miss any content from me. And if you'd like to get to know more about me, do check out my Instagram, TikTok, and Patreon down below.